Hello everyone and welcome to the GMS Magazine YouTube channel. I am Paco Garcia and today I bring you a playthrough Ascension Gift of the Elements. A few days ago, I reviewed the latest installment in the Ascension saga from Stoneblade Studios and designed by Justin Garry, but I felt that review didn't really do it justice to the simplicity of the gameplay and how nice some of the combos and new mechanisms are. So I thought, since the game also comes with a solitary mode, that I will play a game on camera so to show you exactly how it plays, what it does, and how cool the game actually can be, I hope, because, you know, I tend to be very unlucky when I play, but you're about to find out. Without further ado, here's my game of Ascension, Gift of the Elements. This is the standard setup for the game, and for this particular example I am just going to use 30 honor points, hoping that I will finish in about 10 minutes to make sure that the game is as quickly as possible. This is the standard setup with your 6 center row cards. This is your draw pile, and the game comes with these 3 basic cards, the Heavy Infantry, the Mystic and the Cultist, which for a relatively small amount of runes, it gives you a relatively high amount of buying power or defeating power. However, the Cultist, what it does allow you to just give him a slap and you get one reward, one honor point. And it's a fairly cheap thing to actually, you know, give a slap, and you can give it as many slaps as you like throughout the whole game. It's just a way of getting one cheap point. That's all it does. Now here we have 6 cards. We have the Hard Glow Click, which is a life bound hero. It has the empower mechanism, which is very good because it means that once you buy it, it's going to allow you to do something immediately rather than when you redraw it from your discard pile. The non-tribe gremlin, it's going to give you just 1 point, but it has the infest kind of mechanism, which is great. The Oblivion Blossom, which 1 per turn, it's going to give you 1 power point, which is good. And if you have banished a card, any card is going to give you 1 honor point, which is also very good. The Wildbark Mail is a life-bound construct, and once per turn, if you have defeated a monster in the center row, so here, it's going to give you 2 honor points, which can be very, very interesting indeed. And then the Bramble Elemental, which it's going to give you 5 honor points, but also it's going to allow you to discard one of the cards, or punish one of the cards from your hand or your discard pile, which is absolutely brilliant. The Madness Embrace is a void construct, and once per turn, if you have defeated a monster in the center row, you can banish a card with your hand or your discard pile. Now, how does the solitary mode of this game work? It is actually very, very simple indeed. To replicate the opponent at the end of every round, the first 2 cards are going to disappear, and once you take a card from the center row, everything is going to slide towards the right, which is quite interesting. Your initial hand, you're going to have 2 militias and 8 apprentices. Those are going to be shuffle, something like that, but maybe you can do it a bit more elegantly than I do. And I'm going to draw 5 cards. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. That's my initial hand, which is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 apprentices, which is pretty excelente, which is pretty much what I wanted to get. Now, what am I going to do? Well, I am going to spend all of these into buying... What am I going to buy? I'm going to go crazy and buy Hard Glow's Click. Because it has the empower, when you acquire this, I can banish a card that played this turn. So off it goes, because that's also going to give me a two runes, which is great, and two honor points when I play it. So that's more than this, which is why it goes away. That's my discard pile. Off it goes. My opponent goes. These two cards are defeated. Now, this is where things become tricky, because any monster that is meant to go to the opponent, it is as if the opponent had defeated it. So it gets everything. That is getting five honor points that go to my opponents. That's not a good start for me. This comes here. Three cards are drawn to the center. Okay, and I take my five cards, which obviously is going to have the two militia and the three apprentices. Now, what am I going to do with this? You know, in the vain hope that I'm going to get something else later, I'm going to defeat Nom the Tribe Gremlin for 1 point, and I am going to take one honor point. For me, these things get slided to the right. That thing happens, which is exactly what I wanted. I am getting Yuck the Tribe Outcast, which I am going to buy for 3 runes. That comes here, and that card, I can do absolutely nothing with it. So here it comes. Now that I have run out of every card I could draw, this is my discard pile. Shuffle, 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 shuffle. Mega shuffle. You can see that I am not particularly good at shuffling, but that's fine. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. This is going to be my hand. And now the opponent goes, and they take away this and this card. No honor points. All of this comes to the right, and 2 new cards. Prime Directive. This is a very important card, because this is a mechanic construct that comes with a game end mechanism. So basically, if you can control the mechanic construct, the Prime Directive, and you have 8 or more mechanic constructs, if you control them, and that is if they are on the table, then you win the game regardless. It is very hard to do, and this is a very expensive card to get, but it is a very, very good, fun mechanism to try to exploit. Now, this is very annoying, because I get Nom the Tribe Gremlin, which is going to do absolutely Gremlin, which is going to do absolutely nothing for me at this stage, because I don't have Yuck with me in my hand. So that goes away, and my hand essentially is just 4 cards. So I have 1 hit point, which I can do absolutely nothing with, so that goes there, and 3 mana points, which I could either I am going to play safe, and I'm going to get Flourishing Druidess, which is going to cost me 3, but it has the empower, so when I acquire this, I can banish a card. So I am going to banish this card, because again, this thing's going to give me 2 runes anyhow. So off it goes. This come here. Hey, don't complain. I didn't say I was very good playing at this game. I'm just playing it. Okay, and these 2 cards disappear towards the opponent. By the way, this is not particularly good news, because the opponent is going to put, as well as all the little gems that they're getting, all the points that they accumulate at the bottom at the end of the game. So I could easily be defeated by essentially no one, which would be very embarrassing. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 cards. And now I get 1 militia, apprentice, apprentice. Right, so I am getting right now 2, because the hard glow click gives me 2 on a point. And that counts as 2 runes. So I can have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 runes and 1 militia. With the militia, I'm going to kill Nom the Gremlin. Ta-da. Like so. And with my, oh my goodness, with my five, I am going to get Yuck again, and the innovative aspirant. So Yuck doesn't do anything, it only costs me three. But this one, the innovative aspirant, because it has the empower, it allows me to banish a card that I've played this turn, which is going to be this one. Out they come, thank you very much. And that comes here. Ooh, we have an event, Zeron's Trial. When you play a monster, gain 2 points of power. And now we have another element, which is Emry's Trial. When two elements come one after the other, or one lives on the one, the original goes banished and the next one appears. Void event. Monsters in the center row cost 1 point less to defeat, to a minimum of 1 point. Okay, I have shuffled immensely badly. Very bad. Shame on me. But you get the point of what I'm trying to do. Anywho, so Citrus Trial, the heroes in the center row cause one room less to acquire to a minimum of one, which is absolutely mega smashing. These two cards, they go, ow, ow, the enemy is getting Prime Directive. That is brutally painful. Brutally, brutally painful. I am going to be obliterated by no one. One, two cards. Shuffle, shuffle, shuffle. Yeah, very rudimentary, as you can tell. Wave, 3, 4, 5 cards. Ta-da! Okay, now we have Yuck Tribe Outcast, Apprentice, the Phyrexian Druiders. Yes, yes! This is great. This is absolutely brilliant. I am liking this a lot better now. Right, because I draw two Yuckies, I get to draw another two cards, because that's what this thing is telling me to do. So I draw another card, idiot, Githia Mal, boom, and another apprentice. Okay, right, that's not exactly what I wanted, but that's fine, don't worry, don't worry. Now, I can banish a card in the center row. So I am going to banish this, because I cannot defeat it. Oh, yes, I can. Ha! Yes, I can. Right, I'm going to banish this, just because it's there. Then, I can banish Nom, the tribe Gimbling. And I can banish this to acquire or defeat any monster in the center without paying its cost. So I am going to defeat the Wildfire Elemental, which is going to give me 4 honor points. 1, 2, 3. Yeah. And I can choose up to 2 cards in the center and banish them. Now, I don't want to do that right now, because otherwise I'm going to run out of cards, which is not really fun at all. So I'm going to do that, I'm going to do that, I've taken 2 cards in here, yes. I'm going to do that, and this one has been played, that goes to my discard, thank you very much. This one has been played already. Am I going to banish this one? Yes, I'm going to banish this one, so I can get... No, I'm not going to do it now. I'm not going to do it now. So this is good for nothing. This I have already played because I drew the card earlier. And now I gain 2 if I have more honor points than my opponent, which I do because now I have 7. So I have, this is worth 3, 4, and 5. And with 5, I am going to acquire Kiwi, the Meadow Witch, which will allow me later on to draw a card, and if I unite, then it's going to give me 5 honor points. And with that, my hand is empty. This thing comes this way. And a new card appears. And these two cards disappear into my opponent's greasy paws, which are inexistent because I'm playing alone, which is why I'm talking to you, viewer, even though it looks like I'm talking to myself. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 cards are thrown. This is my hand. 1, 2. I'm getting... Oh my goodness, this is getting annoying. Right, okay, so this is worth for nothing. This is good for nothing. Very irritating. I draw 2 of these because it says gain 2 runes and 2 honor points. I have nothing to unite it with, so I don't draw a card. So I have 4 of these beautiful things. So I'm going to take these 2 cards with me, the Verdant Elemental. Well, let's do this first. Verdant Elemental, that gives me 3 points of honor. And put it here. Okay, and now I have. I'm going to buy. Well, this spot for this. Thank you, so I don't get confused, which I could. So very easily, I'm going to buy the King Eye Aspirant, or Spirant, whatever, which is an empower, which says that you can banish any card that you have used this turn. So I'm going to banish this one, because I'm, you know, screw them. There you go. So one comes out, my opponent takes 2 cards. I'm going to lose so badly. Jeez, I am really getting hammered here, I think. 2 cards, I shuffle my discard pile. Okay, discard pile, come on, be nice to me. There you go. As you can see, I barely touched those cards. They are easy to touch when in other games, I don't know, whatever. Right, so Ooh, this is pretty decent. I draw a card because, you know, Yuck tells me to. And I get another card, which is another draw card. Yuck. Hello, Yuck. Okay, good. And I get this thing, which also allows me to draw another card, which is great. Oh, okay, not so great. Because I have Militia. Yay. So what do I get with this? We have... I have nothing to unite Kiri with. So that's annoying, but that's fine. Don't worry about it. And then we get... 1 rune and 1 hero point, thank you, this is mine. No? So we get 1, 2, and 3 runes to spend in whatever I want. And I get 2 and 3 hit points, you know, power points. This is pretty... Now, I don't like this. I don't like this at all. Anyway, so with my 2 militias, because I cannot do anything else, I'm going to give a slap to the cultists, and I'm going to get 1 on a point. Thanks for nothing, or almost nothing. With my 3 runes, I am going to get these 2 cards in here. I know I could get this one, but at least give me 2 points at the very end. And this card, you know, the Innovative Aspirant has an Empower, which means I can banish a card that I use this turn, so that goes away. That's my hand. These 2 cards go to my opponent. This one's going to give it 4 points of Anna. And gets banished, and that card goes there. Yep. Back up. Okay, here we go. Monsters! Monsters galore! Ooh, this is going to be a tough one. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Just so you see, I'm not cheating too much. Ugh. Okay, I can do nothing with none. except I can do nothing with none. This is, oh, you see, this is bad, this is very bad. So we have two honor points that this card is going to give me. I have more honor points than my opponent, so it's going to give me one more. So I get 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. And basically I'm going to do the only sensible thing here, which is get the cell block E, which has cost me everything, which is fine. So that goes here, and we draw one more card, which is another yucky. This card goes here, that goes banished, and it gives, you know, 5 points. So that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 points. That's it, done. The game is now over, and now it's just a matter of counting, you know, victory points that we get. Every card at the bottom has a number of points, so we're going to count them, which is 1. I haven't been using Citrus Trial, I'm an idiot. Completely forgot that this was here. Plonker, never mind. 1, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 30, 2, 4. I have 36. That's absolutely pathetic. Really terrible. Whereas my opponent has got 1, 4, 5, 9, 10, 11, 18, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, and 4, 30, 35, 37, 39, and 40. Yes, yes, I have been beaten by absolutely no one. That was awful. Well, now you can see how badly I lose to no one. So imagine when I play with people. It's just, you know, wondrous to see that happening. Anyway, I hope that this has given you very good ideas to how the game is played. And I hope you have enjoyed this video. Please do give me a thumbs up if you've liked it. And give me a thumbs down if you haven't. And let me know why. Why didn't you like the video? It's always good to know what that kind of opinions. Please, please help us with our Patreon campaign. We'd like to do a lot more videos, much, much better than this, but we desperately need your help in order to be able to do that and to keep abreast and up to date with all the videos that we will be releasing in the future. Please don't forget to subscribe down there. Thanks again, and I'll talk to you very soon.